Hey guys, welcome back, Bear Scare Beauty. Today I'm gonna do viral TikTok makeup hacks and things. Mainly things that I'm like, okay, so some of these things work. Some of them are just really annoying because it's a lot of people that have the attitude of like, oh my God, I just discovered this. It's amazing. Meanwhile, it's things that it's like, yeah, every like makeup artist has known about those for 20 years because it's just like kind of how you're supposed to do makeup. Before we get into that, yeah, you should totally subscribe, like, dislike, comment, say horrible things about me, say great things about me. Either way, it's fine. Yeah, I tried to do it 2021 and then I like stopped uploading. Try it 2022, I'll try for 100 subs. So we're gonna start with one, and I know this one works, it's just annoying because people are, you know, and I'll try to find the actual videos. Some of the videos, I couldn't actually find the one that I saw, and I don't know who originated these. Like, for the life of me, could not find, like, who started these trends on TikTok, who made them go viral or whatever. And as I said, a lot of them are literally just things that are like, yeah, this isn't anything new. This has been going on for 20 years. First hack, powder before foundation. This actually works. I use it pretty frequently. Basically, it just helps kind of mattify you a little more. So this helps. Now, the thing I'm seeing people do is they're like baking under their makeup, which is super weird. That doesn't work. Also, I saw people, and I don't know why you would do this, but people were like using a setting spray, packing powder on, waiting for it to dry, using a setting spray again, and then doing primer on top of that. Can we see the order of operate, like why that wouldn't work? Make sense? Gonna use primer. This is the Good Molecules silicone-free priming moisturizer. Maybe? I don't know. I really like it. It's like $12. It's really good. It really, really, so I use the Krylon TV paint, like for clients and stuff like that. A pump of this mixed in with that looks so good. Oh my God, it looks good. I've also been using this to mix into some of my concealers that are a little more aggressive, let's say. Take it right up under the eyes too. By the way, you want something to look fantastic under your eyes? Just use your eye cream before you do your makeup. It's not that hard. Now, this doesn't sit on the skin at all. It sinks in really fast. So we're gonna do the powder thing. This is the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder. And I'm gonna use that weird little Delium 952 blending brush. I really like these brushes for cream, for cream, if you want to use them with a cream. If you use them with a cream, you really only get 1 to 2 good uses out of them, definitely before you have to wash them. But that's pretty much how you should be washing your brushes anyway, so. Very, very light dusting of powder, and I'm just doing it where I get oily with makeup. So just in the T-zone, I'm trying not really to go right under my eyes, but just on the nose. And then that powder as well is just really good at like mattifying and kind of giving you the illusion of shrinking your pores. This, I mean, if you just did this, and kind of went about your day, you just kind of look like you have really good skin. Did that. I'm gonna use a setting spray. This is the Stay All Night Micro Fine Mist Setting Mist by e.l.f. I don't know how I feel about the setting spray itself. The mister is fabulous though. Just let that kind of chill out on the skin. Next thing we're gonna do. This annoyed the hell out of me. Because it was one of those people that's like, oh my God, guys, I just discovered this amazing new way to do your contour. And I watched it and I lost my mind. I had an out-of-body experience where I was teleported to a battlefield and was just
breaking the enemy.
Oh my god. Okay. The reason why I lost my mind is because it is literally how you contour correctly. The reason why I lost my mind is because it was being treated like some new revelation from the heavens. I about had a stroke. Okay, here we go. I'm just gonna be using the ABH contour palette. Use the little double-domed 792 blending brush. What they did, and it just take a basic makeup course. The way I do it, because now obviously don't really want to touch people's faces, but before I would just touch their face, you take it, you find the ear, and then you kind of wiggle the brush. I find where the person's cheekbone is, mine is right here, and then I go down under it. And that is where you would put your contour, right? You would feel everybody's individual face, feel where their cheekbone ends, go right under the cheekbone. I usually like to drag it back because it kind of gives the illusion more, because most of the time people's faces go like, get bigger around the outside of that. Does that make sense? Your face isn't a flat plane on both sides. It usually is a little more round, you know what I mean. So, what they did is like, okay, find this, and then go where your teeth would be. That's not right. Because, so here's my cheekbone. My cheekbone is right here, right? If you feel it, right here. Right under my cheekbone is right here, right? My teeth start right here. That is way too low and way too far in for my contour. This is my jaw. Like, this is my lower jawbone right here, right? My teeth do not start. This is my very back tooth right here. And here is my cheekbone. Here is where my teeth start. That's like a good 3/4 inch below. I would usually contour maybe half that. Anyway, okay. So, here's my teeth. Be a little generous. So they want me to put my contour right here. I would do it usually right here. That's a fair bit up from it, but we're gonna do it. Find teeth on the other side. I'll see if I can get it more or less symmetrical. And then we're going to contour up, and they said follow your teeth. So, I mean, that's... See, I'm not even following what they're doing because I'm blending it back and up. No, they just kind of did this. That has given me a villainous cheekbone. Like, I look like a Disney villain. I know I'm gonna regret this, but I just picked up a little bit more on my brush because it's not blending as far as I need it to. That is a lot! Oh my god. I look like a damn villain now. It also reminds me a little bit of like a drag technique where you would really bring it in, which probably where it came from, because apparently we're going back to 2016, not just with makeup culture, but general internet culture. I hate it here. By the way, this is at least a semi-nice departure from the you contour in a number 3, which is also the wrong way to contour, because that's everybody's face is different. You need to work on your face.
I'm just gonna contour like I usually would.
And this was something that also another person was... I found a new way to contour. Contouring your temples. That's not new. It's never been new. It's not something that should be thought of as new. And this... makeup 101. By the way, once again, my real main issue with this is it being treated like it's some revolutionary new, oh my god, I just discovered this. It's like, no, you did nothing. This is so basic. I feel like everybody knows where this is going when you pick up tweezers. The contouring your nose with tweezers hack is back at it again. I don't like this trend for what I hope should be obvious reasons, because this isn't a nose. So I got contour on it. Let me, oh god. Okay, not enough went on there apparently. Like, do you see that? That's not really the shape of my, I mean, that's not the shape of my nose at all. Why am I shaking so bad? I got the shakes apparently, Jesus. Yeah, that's not the shape of my nose. That's never been the shape of my nose, but give the audience what they want. So, I mean, if you really want to contour your nose, just follow where your brow meets your nose and you can just take it down. And then obviously, if you want to make your nose, you know, give it that kind of snatched appearance, just bring it in a little bit. Like, this isn't a quick way to get a nose contour because it doesn't really work. It's not the shape of your face, you know? Also, I just put it on crooked. I feel like it's very hard to line up properly because it's like, you know, you're off center a little bit and it's crooked. This leads into the next hack, which is the button nose. I get it, I guess, but it just, it looks weird. And I feel like it doesn't really work on a lot of people. So you would just do the sides of your nose, cut it off at the tip, so you have a very squared off tip of your nose. I don't know how well you'll be able to see this on camera. You can kind of see it. And then you just cut another square. So you have just made a box at the tip of your nose. Do we see that? Do we see the box I've made at the tip of my nose? I don't particularly have a big problem with this, but it doesn't really work on everybody's face. And it does, I mean, obviously it doesn't look natural. Makeup doesn't have to look natural. That's fine. But it just, it's a little jarring looking. You kind of look like a toy soldier. It just kind of comes out of nowhere. So it's a little weird. Oh, and you don't blend that line at all. It's just there. Another one that I saw, I don't like it. I don't like it. Your eyebrow color is supposed to be your perfect lip color, and people were just using their eyebrow pencil to line their lips. I don't know about this one, chief. Let's do it. Okay. So I'm just eyebrows, but we'll get there. Brows on, symmetrical, not really. I hate this. I hate what I'm about to do. Oh, another hack. All before foundation. Wild, right? Okay. Scrunch your lips. So you scrunch your lips and then you just kind of line around it? Well, I hate the color, first of all. And this is coming from a bitch that wears black lipstick. The brows lip thing, that is a yikes from me, dog. That's a yikes. That's a yikes from me. Okay, so the lip scrunching thing, I think it gave me a decent outline, but it's not really what I go for. You kind of have to play connect the dots with the corner of your lips too. Okay. Foundation. Oh, I forgot about this. Oh no. Hold on. Do you know what time it is, my little scare cubs? It's time to mix your favorite water-based lubricant into your foundation. My lube of choice is always gun oil. Support our troops. This is a water-based gun oil. They make silicone. Make sure if you're gonna do this, get water-based, because Okay, so I'm gonna start Pump Makeup Forever. I'm using a kind of lighter weight foundation to let the contour show through, so I'm just doing a pump of that. Oh, I'm gonna try to get just a small globule. I don't like lube on my face in general. Who likes lube on their face? Oh god. I feel like one drop is enough. Since I've already dirtied my tweezers, I'm just gonna... That is a consistency, alright. Oh my god. It's like curdling the foundation. Now, I saw people doing this like lube as a primer or mixing it into your foundation. So I saw it both ways. I don't really see how it would be much different because it's not really gonna dry down the way you think it would. God, there's contour all over my fingers now. Okay, so there is one thing about water-based lube that I will kind of give this hack. Water-based lubricant does dry down to like a sticky and then like really dry stage. Interesting enough. I mean, I guess not really interesting. That's why I chose this. I feel like that just intensely diluted the coverage. So go back in with another. I'm just gonna do two full pumps of the Makeup Forever. I mean, it's not the highest coverage foundation, so I get it. But it usually doesn't take me more than two pumps with it. So I guess we're gonna do one and... Also, lubricant is like plastic and rubber polymers, basically, that are water soluble or silicone soluble. So like, it's not super great for your face skin, because if you think about it, your private parts, your between me down there, your what's gone sour, you know, that Coco Von, doesn't have pores. The skin obviously around it does, but the organ, the member, I can already feel it. Like, if you're familiar with lubricants, you'll know the feeling that I'm talking about. I can already feel it getting like tacky, like sticky. And that's not a feeling that I happen to enjoy. Oh my god. It's like sticking to the brush? So it's like making it all like floppy. It's making my brush flaccid. And lubrication and flaccid are not a super like spectacular combination. I'm not digging how this looks. You know, with how pale, pasty, and pallid I look, I'm kind of thinking about just fake tanning year round. I do not tan. I've already had immense sunburns my whole life, high risk of skin cancer, so I don't fuck around with tanning beds. I'm just gonna take my sponge and just, because it doesn't look great. And this foundation with that brush always looks fantastic. So I'm not appeased with this. The contour doesn't look good where it was placed. I don't particularly like where it was placed. It really did just give me these villainous cheekbones. And I mean, I already have an angular face anyways, so, you know, I can't do the lube thing. I'm doing four pumps of this foundation. This foundation doesn't do well with a sponge, I will say that right now, but I'm just going to take the sponge and I'm going to go over the contoured areas just a little bit more, just to give them a tiny bit more coverage, and then just down the gobble. I'm not a fan. It feels tacky. I can feel it like crusting on my face, if that makes it. It's like, I can feel it like seizing on my face. I don't like it. Not cash money, not what I would call great. I didn't see any concealer hacks. I'm sure there are concealer hacks, other than the shaping thing. The shaping thing, once again, incorrect. I mean, correct, but incorrect. It really depends on your face shape. Figure out your face shape, go from there. I guess I will do that one, just for funsies, just fine. People were doing the drag contour, so I'll do it, but I gotta do it way lower because the contour's really low. God, that contour just made me look like I'm gonna fucking kill you. Like,
I don't like it. I don't like it, not at all.
Take a little bit on my sponge, because that face shape, not working for me. It just doesn't particularly work on my face. I need a little bit of, I need a little bit of brightening, like, on the cheekbone to kind of bring my cheeks out more, because I have a very flat face, but it's very angular, so I kind of need to make my face look a little more round on my cheeks, because otherwise I just look very, like, poised and very flat. And I mean, to the credit of the shape of concealer, if it works on you, it looks good, right? It's a great way of using a technique to lift what your face looks like. I am gonna powder this down before it creases. I got this little like fuzzy sponge. I haven't wet it. I do like it just to kind of tap powder on. I'm not baking, I'm just tapping a little bit. I'm like getting some on it and then tapping the excess off. A little bit of powder right where I need it. So like kind of right under the eyes, between my eyebrows, because I have a massive crease there, and then where the creases on my forehead are. Oh God, and before I powder the rest of my face, I forgot to re-accentuate my nose. Look, I haven't filmed in months. I'm a mess, okay? The wheels are falling off. We'll do it real quick. It's fine, it's easy. Once again, we're doing the button nose thing, so just a line straight down the nose, and then where that square was, just a little dot of concealer.
Ever so gently blend it out. Take whatever's left on this powder, tap it on.
I do hit the sides of my nose and my nasal labial folds just because they crease a lot. Okay. And I'm just gonna dust it off. Kind of sweep it around the rest of my face. Kind of use whatever's left to help set the rest of my face.
Wow, that lube trick has decided to show up every tiny dry patch on my skin. And I used hydration. Hydration and a hydrating nice emollient foundation. That's a bad, this is bad. Don't do this. I can also feel it on my face. It feels very like constricting. It feels like I'm wearing a mask. I don't like it. Not fun. I am gonna take a little bit more loose powder on a brush, and I'm just gonna kind of set the low. Ooh, that was a lot of loose powder. That was more than I intended. That is on me. Look it. Gonna go in with the powder contour now.
This is the Wayne Goss number 4 brush. I like this for contouring because it was expensive and I'm going to use it. Yikes.
So I'm just gonna try to follow where that contour was. Doesn't look great on me. Just saying.
If it's something you want, you can go ahead and do it. You can do whatever you want. I'm not your dad. You're an adult.
It's a yikes.
Can you even see?
Big yikes.
Gonna take my Wayne Goss 2 brush, and I'm going to use this to just gently dab over the contour.
Oh, I hate that. Oh, I hate that. Oh God, I also hate the feeling of the foundation with this. Jesus, oh God, I look
messy. I hate this. I hate the using your eyebrow shade as a lip liner. Not gonna be the business for everybody. Just saying. Especially not for me. Okay, I'm gonna use finishing powder. This is one that went viral. It's the NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop finishing powder. There was a video and they're like, oh my god, it blurs your pores instantly. No pores. Here's the thing. That's a lie. It is a very good finishing powder though. I really like it as a finishing powder. I think it sets everything nicely. It does blur, like it has a blurring property a little bit. Nothing even close to that TikTok though. I'll post a picture of it using good makeup that aren't hacks. I'll just insert it right here. That aren't hacks with this powder, and I thought it looked divine. Like my skin looked amazing. And I just dusted this over set makeup and it looked fabulous. I mean, even now, it still looks good. Low camera quality and filters. That's all that thing was. This product is going viral. Oh my god, look at that. It touches my skin, my pores are gone. It's not how this works. I'll give it a fair shot. She was using a very dense paddle brush. I'll use a very dense paddle brush. This is the Delium Tools Golden Triangle 960 Precision Blush Brush. I have loaded it with this damn powder, all right? Oh my god. Oh my god, my pores. They're gone. They're really not. It does look good though. It does look good. Like, I will admit, it looks good. It's a good finishing powder. There's nothing wrong with saying it is a good finishing powder, right? It's just not what that viral TikTok showed it to be. And that's A, incredibly misleading. B, almost leads me to believe that NYX is paying people to make those claims, which they could very well be, and not disclosing it, which is illegal, by the way, but they very well could be. Y'all have probably heard the blush thing where it's the person like putting on the blush and it's the, no, yes. I hate that audio. I fucking hate that audio so much. Flames on the side of my face. Heat, heaving, burning. Madeline Kahn. Hate it. Since they want it to be more concentrated, I'm gonna take that Wingoss 2 brush. This is the Pat McGrath Labs. I think this is Venus? Venus? Nude Venus. Lovely girl. Lovely color. Lovely girl. Swirl into that. And so they don't want you to put blush here. Hello? They don't want you to put blush here. They don't want you to put blush here. All here. Very 1980s. Very 1980s. And, you know, once again, you gotta go with what works on your face shape. This does not work on my face shape. I do like putting blush all the way back here, but I also need to bring it down onto the center, onto the apple of my cheeks, because otherwise my face looks flat. It looks like I have a flat face, which I do, but I don't want to look like that. I want to look like I have a nice plucky, cherubic, round face. I love me a lot of blush though. I love me a lot of blush, darling. I do love me a lot of blush. I like to look sunburned and haggard. Yeah. Yeah, baby, yeah. See, but look at that. All the blush concentrated right here. And I feel like it completely like flattens out the front of my face. It's not something I enjoy. It's not something I believe works on me or my face shape. It's all about your face shape. Taking the Wingoss 1 brush. Gonna dip into the Makeup Armoria. I think it's the lightest one. This is Soft Sculpt Bronzer Light. Yeah, this is a great bronzer, by the way. Overpriced. Good bronzer, but definitely overpriced. This lip shade, this, these lips. Ain't it, Chief? I feel like on camera I look a little more insane. No, it's pretty insane in person. See, okay, so I like a lot of blush. I like a lot of blush right here, too. I think it gives you that, like, kind of, it's like a, like, almost like an editorial 1980s fashion show vibe. I like it. I like that. It's fine. I need it right here, though. Oh my god. Also, taking blush right gently, right under the eyes, too, it gives you such a nice, like, kind of blush look, which blush is supposed to, but it just makes you look happy. It makes you look healthy. I don't feel like this makes me look healthy. I think it makes me look flat and then it looks like I contoured doing this. That's exactly what it looks like, which I don't like because that doesn't work on my face or my face shape. It's a no for me. We're gonna do one more thing. We're going to do the white contour. Now, I don't have the jumbo pencil and I already set my face. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna dip into this white from the, this is a BH Doja Cat Mega Palette. Watch my video on that. It's not a great collection, which is sad. I'm gonna take, this is my little angle blending brush, 776 angle blending brush. I'm gonna dip into that white. And they literally want you to highlight with white. So, yeah, but I'm using a very light hand and a very sparing amount with this. Now, here's the thing. This isn't necessarily a bad technique. It's just a drag technique. Drag queens highlight with white all the time because you're painting for the back of the room. Here's the thing. When you do this with normal makeup, it makes you look a little ghastly, right? I don't know. Yeah, I mean, oh my god. Oh my god, on camera. Oh, fucking hell. Ooh, hold on. Ooh, on camera, that looks like just straight up white stripes on my face. I can promise you in person it doesn't look that... I say that, but it looks kind of insane. Here's the thing. If you want to highlight with white, I would suggest doing it when you do your foundation. The white powder just looks kind of weird. In person, it looks kind of weird. On camera, especially, I can tell, like, right there and right there. Oh, jeebus. Looks like I'm wearing a white powder. I don't like that technique for everyday normal makeup. It looks weird. It looks good on camera depending on how you do it, but then in person you're like, you have a white stripe on your face, and I feel like Jack White isn't the one, you know? All right, I just primed my eyes, Urban Decay Primer Potion. The foundation is already breaking apart around my nose and right where the dry patches were. And in my forehead creases, it's like literally breaking apart, so not great. Eyes. We're gonna do the thing. We're gonna do the stripes and then blend them all together. So I'm gonna try that because my eyes are drastically different shapes, so you know. Though I suppose when they're all blended together, it's probably gonna look kind of the same. Which is great. Symmetry or whatever. You know, I'm doing a pink, and then I'm doing kind of a dusty pink. Yeah, it's a little darker. Yeah. There we go, dusty pink. Now, usually I see the people put it on dark to light. I'm not gonna do that because I'm just gonna use the same brush to put it on. And then we're doing a deep kind of reddy pink on the outside. I did see people putting shimmer on and blending it out with that, so I guess. Pretty shimmer. Pretty. Oh god, if y'all haven't, how old are you people that watch my videos? If y'all haven't, you need to watch Female Trouble by, oh my god, why am I forgetting his name? Queer Icon. John Waters. It's not today's standards. It's highly offensive. It's very queer. It's very angry. There's a lot of crude humor. Fabulous movie, though. Fabulous.
Who wants to be famous? Who wants to die for art?
All right, let's blend. Blend. I saw a lot of people just like swiping through the entire thing, so I guess that's what we're gonna do. Yeah, the shimmer, I guess this is almost more of a glitter. It's just kind of going everywhere. That's about what I expected. Oh. My weird bald patches are showing up. This is not due to the hack, this is just my eyes. I mean, yeah, it doesn't look terrible. It looks a bit like I put three stripes of eyeshadow on, right? It doesn't look bad. It's not bad. It's just a bit, I feel like I went very conservative on the amount that I chose to put down. And I think I needed to use a lot more with this technique. So, and that's, I guess, something is the technique would have a learning curve, which is fine. A little weird for a hack. But it's not bad. It's not terrible. The hack worked, I suppose. It's just not what I would choose to do. That actually made a big difference. Yeah, 6 out of 10. It's workable, it's serviceable, not fantastic, not terrible. 6 out of 10. All right, we're gonna finish it off with lips. God, not a fan of this. I'm just gonna reline real quick just to make sure it's cool. Hate the color. Using your eyebrow pencil as a lip liner, not great. It's kind of smearing, not splendid. I'm gonna go with a color that I actually like, but we're gonna use another hack. We're gonna take the Q-tip. We're doing this.
Colourpop Ultra Matte Lip in, I think this is like City something?
Times Square. Now, do you see the problem? I just have two gaping like holes on the side of my mouth where there's no lipstick. And it's not a great look. Like, okay, when you're just regular, no. Even when you're regular talking, you can see it. Okay. The eyeshadow looks fine. Actually, now that I'm getting a second look on it, it looks good. It's fine. 7 out of 10. All right, there we have it. Yes, so what do we think of the final look? I'm not really a fan. I think the contour makes my face look way too pointed. The blush just being right here makes it look too flat, kind of leaves a void area between that and the contour, which should be where my contour is, but I bronzed, so it kind of elongated my face a little bit. The white highlight looks super weird and a little off-putting. The brow pencil color, hate that. The Q-tip thing looks bad because then you have those two holes and you just have to play connect the dots anyways and it looks the same. And the lube, terrible. Don't do that. Just don't do it. It doesn't look good. The eyeshadow thing actually worked pretty good. I'm okay. She can stay. The eyeshadow thing can stay. Is that the only one that I like? Oh, I don't like the button nose contour either. That's personal preference. I just don't think it looks good on me. Oh, and the tweezer contour. Why? Don't do that. It looks dumb. You get your tweezers messy. Just don't. Even my brush agrees. Just don't do it. Thank you so much for watching, my little scare cubs. Once again, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, and YouTube. Bear Scare Video, same way it's spelled here. Videos, whatever. Stream, whatever. Instagram, whatever. But yeah, I love you guys so much. Hope you have a good day, week, month, or year. Bye.